Greetings, ladies and gentlemen. Before I get into what we're doing today, which is probably obvious by the title of the video and what you see on the screen here, let me quickly apologize for the lack of videos this week. I'll be completely honest, I was basically just stressed from a lot of real-life stuff that's pointless to get into, and just in combination with videos, it's been hard to keep up with Zukanov and other videos lately, so I just took a quick week break, just 1 week break, so that's all. That's all I'm going to say about it. It's not a big deal. It was 1 week. I'm sure most of you understand. I really do appreciate that. Anyway, today we're back opening Pokemon cards. What the heck? Yes, I used to do these a good amount way back when. I said I wasn't going to do any more at one point because they're too expensive and I don't really do much with them. But you know what? I don't know what it was, but lately I've been really wanting to get back into the trading cards. I don't, just opening them and maybe playing the online game a little bit, what difference does it make? It's my money, I'll do what I want with it. So I decided to buy a booster box of Phantom Forces. And I'm wondering, why Phantom Forces of all the sets I could have bought a booster box of? Well, I tend to buy based on what Pokemon are included. As you can see right here on these two booster packs right up front, we've got Gengar and Aegislash. They're in my top six favorites. And who also is in my top favorites? Feraligatr and Crobat are my top two Pokemon, literally, and they're both in this set as stage two Pokemon. Gengar and Aegislash are actually EXs, so whatever. We are just going to start opening them and see what happens. I have not done these in a long time, so I'm actually really excited to see what happens with this. All right, here's an online card. Speaking of the online card game, I've been kind of into it lately. Just playing it a little bit on my own, not really that much, but enough for me to think that I want to keep these cards to maybe use for future stuff, whatever. Hey, so I like to rearrange the cards just so the rarest card is in back. That's just how I like to do it. I don't have any problem with other people doing it other ways. That's just how I like to do it. So we've got Gulpin, Spearow, Pumpkaboo, Litleo, Swirlix. I think this is my very first fairy card ever. The last set I bought from was Plasma Freeze, if you guys remember that. Plasma Freeze was the last set I ever bought from, so first fairy Pokemon I've ever gotten is Swirlix, at least in the trading card game. Got an Enhanced Hammer. That's not a new card. It was a reprint. Pharaoh. Ooh, Psychic Mystery Energy. Cool. I like that because I like running psychic decks, personally. I'm not competitive anyway, but I like playing the online game on occasion. I like psychic decks. We've got Reverse Holographic AZ. What does AZ do? Oh, bring it to your hand. Okay, so like a super scoop up without flipping a coin. And our rare is X-Plowed. He looks okay. Alright, so anyway, I tend to go through cards somewhat fast. I'll stop when there's something I want to say about one. I really do like artwork of cards, so I'll usually comment on ones that I think are really good. Or maybe I won't if I don't even think to say anything. I don't know. This is just a fun little thing for me. It's not meant to be a I don't know. What's a good word? It's meant to be like just a relaxed, casual video where I open cards and enjoy it. So anyway, we got Dino, Karrablast, Roggenrola, Bunnelby, Skarmory, Furfru. What is it? Okay. Lysander's Trump card. Oh, of course I'm gonna get that. I'm gonna get a million of this. You know why? Because this card is banned. You can't use this card in legal tournaments because it's completely broken. I will, like, when they first released this card, I did keep up with the cards a little bit, not a whole lot. I did keep track of some things, and yeah, this card's ridiculously broken. You just play every single one of your discard cards, go back into your deck. Just like that. Whatever. Croconaw, oh yeah, we're getting somewhere. Oh, I want to make a Feraligatr-based deck. I'm telling you, it's going to happen. Gengar Spirit Link. If we get a Mega Gengar, that'll be helpful. And what the heck? Head Ringer Flare. This attack for the Pokemon's card attached to cost... What is this? Okay. I don't know what this card is, guys. I literally don't know. It looks like a super rare. Look how holographic it is. I think it's a super rare of some sort. It's like a tool card that you put on the opponent's Pokemon. That's really interesting. Wow. I guess this is a good thing. I've never seen this kind of card before. Like, I think I've seen it in the online game, but I didn't know it was like super rare. Because it was in the spot of the rare, and it's clearly like super shiny. Cool. I'm going to keep all of my super rare cards, like, all along in the back row here, and I'll go through them again at the end. All my others, I'm just going to toss. I'll organize them later. All right. Next up, we got this Gengar pack. So, yeah, I'm really hoping for... The cards I'm really hoping for are... Couple for alligators and Crobats, because I want to make a deck based around them, but that'd be more important than the online thing than I guess I could say. Because they don't equate to exact cards as online, they're randomly generated. So whatever. I would like a Mega Gengar and Mega Aegislash. Not Mega Aegislash, but EX, you know what I mean. Alright, Seawaddle, Chansey, Goomy, Krabby, Bronzor, Bulldore, versus Seeker, Lampent. Oh, Chandelure's in this deck too. I didn't know that. Ooh, Hydreigon, reverse holographic. That's a really good one. At least in terms of rarity, yeah. I don't plan to use it all. I'm not a fan of the dragon type in the game, but it's really a nice card. And Swalot. Okay, that's okay, I guess. Alright, let's try this Mega Manectric. What do you got for me, Mega Manectric? Dino. Gligar, Sting! It's Sting. This pack is gonna be horrible. Watch. Litwick. Yanma. Totodile! Yes! And Crocodile. Now we just need the big one to round it all off. We're probably gonna get more Totodiles, just so you know. They're a common. Target Whistle. I've never seen that card before either. Put a basic player for a card back on it. What? How is that helpful to you? Okay, I can see how, like, a really specific situation. Like, let's say you're holding a Lysandre card, which can switch the opponent's Pokemon with one of their benched. Use this card, bring a really weak Pokemon out of their bench, then quickly Lysandre the weak Pokemon out and kill in one hit, and get a cheap prize card. So, very, very specific use. And this reveals it or her hand. I don't know why anyone would play that ever. Swadloon. Reverse Dino, okay. I've got all these Dinos and a Hydreigon, maybe I should play a Dragon deck. And ooh, Holographic Slurpuff! It's funny, because remember, Swirlix was the first fairy Pokemon ever opened, so the first holo of this is a Slurpuff! Nice! It's got Tasting, you may draw a card. You may draw one more card. Okay, that's like the same ability as Plasma Crobat from, I think it was either Plasma Freeze or Plasma Storm. I actually made a deck built around Plasma Crobat in... Black and White days, which was, you know, the only days I really caught. The last time I really caught up with the stuff. Yeah, I'm not competitive at all, like I've said a billion times already. But yeah, I like building decks based on Pokemon I like and then doing things people don't expect. So Murkrow, Fletchling, Helioptile, Finian. What's a Finian? I've never heard of this Pokemon. It's such a... A number of random, stupid, pointless Pokemon. Sorry to Finian fans out there. Poochyena. Fletchinder. Zerosic. Yeah, it's... Okay. Loudred. Ooh, reverse Litwick. I like Litwick. And it's psychic. I like psychic Pokemon. It's not really psychic in the game. They just decided to lump psychic, ghost, and poison as one type in here. Musharna is the rare. Dream of Memory, shuffle three card, okay, I don't know why you need a stage one supporter Pokemon that doesn't really attack at all. Alright, I'm gonna grab some random packs now. Like, this is one from the back! Probably gonna mess up the whole pattern of how these things are supposed to go by opening them out of order. I'll just grab whichever one I feel like. It's not gonna make a huge difference. Or, I mean, there's not gonna be a consistency whatsoever. So don't expect consistency, even though I like consistency. I like to upload videos on a set schedule and stuff, even though I haven't lately. Gulpin, Frillish, Totodile, yay, more Totodiles! Alolamola, Dedenne, Sligoo, Zerosic, another Lysandre's trump card, great. Ooh, reverse Kingler, that's nice. And we got a holographic Gorgeist, nice. It kind of sucks, but it's really shiny and nice looking. Alright, the next one, I'll just grab this Aegislash here, because Aegislash, he wants to be found in his EX form, very much. Because that would be nice. Alright, so now we have a Joltik, Dedenne, Purloin, Helioptile, Carablast, Wobbuffet, Shauna. Yeah, I like the Shauna card personally. I like the supporters that they've been adding. I like Shauna. It's like a one card less than Professor Oak's new theory of the Heart Gold Soul Silver days. Trick Coin, interesting card. You can flip a coin again if you want. Liepard. Oh, it's Reverse Hollow. I couldn't tell because yeah, Dark Reverse Hollow doesn't look that different. I mean, it looks different. It's just hard to tell sometimes because like a dark shininess, which is, you know, an oxymoron. But whatever. The rare is Honchkrow. I like Honchkrow. I think it's a pretty decent card. I like dark decks as well. So maybe I can make something based off of Honchkrow. I don't like playing, because like I said, I don't play competitive. I don't like playing decks that are, you know, common. Or I like to look at all the cards, pick Pokemon I like, or Pokemon I think are good, and make a deck based around them. Anyway, those are two cards. I forgot who they were by now. Alolmola Dedenne, Litwick, AZ, Fletchinder, Dimension Valley. Each psychic. Oh, it's a psychic Pokemon Stadium. Nice. Loudred. Escavalier. That's a rare. Couldn't tell. It's not that interesting to me. Oh boy. Yeah. These have not been doing so well so far. This is the only super rare we've got. I didn't even know this was a super rare card. It's not all that impressive to me. I mean, like, I'd rather get a really cool Pokemon than an item card that I don't even know if I'll ever use. But again, these are the physical versions of the cards, not the digital. The digital ones are the only ones I'm really going to use in games, because I don't have any people in real life to play with. Skarmory, Pumpkaboo, Chansey, Muna, Bronzor, Enhanced Hammer, Pharaoh. Ooh, another psychic special energy, nice. Reverse Furfru, and Galvantula, great. I like Galvantula, but it's not holographic. That's not nice. It's gotta be holographic, guys, come on. Alright, let's pull from the back this time. Come on, Beyonce! Come on, give me some. Give me something good. We've got Purloin, Sea Waddle, Frillish, Dino, Gligar, Sting, Gengar Spirit Link, Kingler. Delicolous Energy, that's always helpful. Dedenne Reverse Holographic, and yes! Finally, an EX Florges. I didn't even know Florges was in this. I forgot. Yeah, another one of my favorite Pokemon, Floette. And of course, Florges is not the one that's going to be the star of it because it's the final evolution, but still, heck yes, I am very happy about that. Nice. All right, you're going to stay back here, Florges. Nice job for, you know, existing. Now we're going to take you. Oh, yeah. Hold on, I'm putting my cards on the floor so they're not in my way. All right, sorry, my dogs keep interrupting me. Wait, we've got Frillish, Helioptile, Purloin, Venonat, Muna, Girafarig, versus Seeker, Loudred, ooh, reverse Deoncé, nice, Sparkle, I get Sparkle, it looks very sparkly, and then we've got, oh my god, a full art Florges, we just got the regular Florges and the full art, wow, I think there's a design, I should play a fairy deck with Florges as the main, I wouldn't mind that at all, because I love Floette, as you all know. If you pay attention and to what my favorite Pokemon are and stuff like that. Oh, I love that. That is very good. That's actually usable because I have two of the same EX. I mean, it's real life cards, so they're really just going to be collectible, sit in my binder and do nothing. But that is quite okay. I am very okay with that because that is, you know, speaking of all the things I've been saying, I've been thinking, what would you guys think if I did the virtual version of all of these pack openings? I could enter all the codes myself, enter all the codes, and then open all of the digital versions of these packs. It'll be a separate video, of course, I can make it really quickly. It'll be much faster than this, because, you know, you click the pack, and it shows you all the cards that are in it. I wouldn't even have to read them all out. I'd skim through them, basically, because since you guys have been seeing the real versions of these cards, it's not like, I would only point out, like, important ones. And this is something new, a Romo Substitute? It's a 30 HP Pokemon, and you can't take prizes for it. That's weird. I feel like I recall something like this existed at one point in the old days. Maybe not? I don't know. I feel like it was. I don't know. I could be wrong. Roller Skates. Swadloon. Reverse Venonat. Nice. And then Exploud. That's two Explouds for... Yeah, and he's a boring rare. Alright, we've got... Next, we've got... Gengar EX. At least that's who's on the booster back box thing, the package. Not who's necessarily in here. Wouldn't that be amazing if it was, though? Murkrow, Venonat, Finneon, another one of him, Litleo, Goomy, Fletchinder, AZ, Danger Valley, Reverse Giraffe Rig, and... Yeah,
you've got to be kidding.
Guys, that is incredible. Oh my god, full art Gengar EX! In the pack with Gengar, I said time to open Gengar EX. I was referring to the package, not the card inside. That's amazing. Oh my god, that is amazing. Now, if only I can get this thing in the virtual version so I can, you know, use it, but... Oh, that is incredible. I love it. Oh, it's so shiny, and it's Gengar. Oh boy. Alright, well, this is really good so far. I was skeptical until we found the first floor just, but now we've been doing really well. It's probably because I'm opening them randomly. I'm not going in order. So there's not really going to be a consistency to, I don't know, what we find. But that's so cool. I love it. I did not expect that at all. That's incredible. You guys, I have it on film. I made a accidental prediction that turned out to be true. Finally, something of the Zubat line. Zubat, Bunnelby, Fletchling, Carablast, Target Whistle, Handscope, Swadloon, Reverse Sting. Great. And then Blissey. Okay. Blissey. Also, some of you might be wondering, why do you keep saying Sting when you look at Gligars? A lot of people don't know that reference. It's mostly a running gag with live stream things, because it originated during a live stream. Basically, I did a live stream playthrough at one point of Pokemon Mystery Dungeon Blue Rescue Team, which I really wish I had saved highlights of, but I didn't, so it's lost forever. Anyway, there was a Gligar I recruited at one point in it, and I named him Sting, and he did absolutely nothing. Even when I set his technique to go after enemies, he did nothing at all. Here's another one! He keeps coming back! That's four Gligar so far, I'm pretty sure. One of them has been reverse holographic. So yeah, this is a running gag of Pokemon that I hate. Because, oh, it's Sting! Not to get out of here! You don't do anything. And yay, Crocodile! Manectric Spirit Link, Enhanced Hammer, and... Oh, it's not the rare yet. Or is it? It's Diggersby. Who would have... Diggersby's not rare. I hate Diggersby. Sorry to people who like Diggersby, or want to say the Diggersby though thing. I hate Diggersby very much. It's awful! And I guess, in general, I really don't hate any Pokemon, really. I just, I don't know, hate's an easy word to throw around when you excessively dislike a Pokemon because of random reasons. I don't know. Those were three Pokemon that we've seen already, so I'm not going to bother reading all of them. Shauna! Yay, another Shauna! I like Shauna. I don't like her in the X and Y games, but I like her card. Wait, what does Wobbuffet do? Okay. Reverse Lampent and Venomoth. Alright, well, I got a couple Venonats, so, Okay, I can see it being an okay card, maybe, kinda, sorta. Probably not really. Probably not at all. I'm probably just talking nonsense like usual. That is fine. Whatever, I've gotten two full arts and a regular EX so far, so I feel like that's pretty good. I feel like that's pretty good already, so if we don't get any more, I would understand. I'll be a little upset, but I will still understand. All right, things we've seen before. Lots of more. Ooh, Steel Shelter. Steel Hogemon can't be affected by special condition. Okay, so a quick standing to throw in around a steel type deck. Or metal, as the technical type is called in the TCG, but I could never call it that. Ooh, Klefki! Nice! Okay, Klefki's a quick... Another thing specific for metal decks, that would be a quick basic to throw around. And hey, it's another Honchkrow, okay. So more than one of the same, you know, you could usually build decks around it. Because if you only have one of a certain card, you know, it's hard to build a deck around it. That is the struggle, at least in my experience, with creating a deck. You never have enough of the card you want to build it around, so you have to trade or buy more. Yanma Joltik, Sting! Finneon, Squirrelix, Wobbuffet, Shauna, Tricoin, Reverse Bulldor, and Hydreigon. Okay, cool, so we have two Hydreigons. One was reverse, one was regular holographic. Nice. Okay. It's only because when I opened him the first time, I was like, eh, I'm not that big of a fan of the dragon type, so guess what? I'm going to find a bunch of them now, because I asked Karma to do that, or, what's the word? There's a word for it. I don't think Karma's the right word. I don't know, reverse psychology to the world? I don't know. Krabby! This is making me crabby! Bronzor, Dino, No, Terra Blast, Raganrola, Steel Shelter, Zweilous. I think that's the first Zweilous we've gotten. So we've got two Hydreigon before we got a single Zweilous. Klefki, Gumi, Mighty Yena, and... Oh, that's the rare. Who thinks of Mighty Yena as rare? It's one of the beginning Pokemon of the Hoenn games. At least, the, you know, the final evolution of it. It's kind of like the Rattata equivalent. I mean, I know Zigzagoon's... More likely the Rattata equivalent of that generation, but there can be multiples. How about it's like the Sentret of that generation? Or is the Sentret the Rattata of Gen 2? You get the idea. It's a weak Pokemon you find early on. So I would not think of it as rare. Yay, more Croconaw! If only we could get it for Alligator! Gengar Spirit Link, Chansey Reverse Holographic, and Leavanny! Okay. I like Leavanny, but... It's not shiny or EX. I like EXs because they're shiny, but I don't know. I feel like most decks are built around a specific EX. I'm not a fan of doing that. I'll throw in an EX or two, probably more, you know, two or three of one specific Pokemon, but build the deck around something else because I don't know. Usually they're really strong. They're really easy to kill things with. Very good strategy. Ooh, yeah, a Sycamore! And finally a Golbat. Now I just need Crobat. Please, a Crobat. Or reverse Bronzong. Blah, blah, blah. Another Mighty Yena. Great. I forgot what I was saying before that. Like, I completely forgot what I was saying before that. Way to go, me. I just dropped all the cards. I didn't see them, but I dropped them all. Alright, we got us a Purloin, Helioptile, Terrablast, Dino, Sting. How many is that? It's a lot so far. Steel Shelter, Gengar Spirit. We've gotten three Gengar Spirit Links, but only a regular Gengar, not a Mega. So those are all useless. AZ, Reverse Pumpkaboo, and Diggersby. Tigrespeed. Wow. Okay, other than our super rares, I feel like the rest of the cards I've gotten have been terrible. Like, only a few of them have been holographic, but... I don't know, maybe I haven't opened these in a while, and I don't know what the ratio is supposed to be. I'm gonna hope it's that. Alright. Bunnelby, Krabby, Gumi, Pumpkaboo, Chachi, Tierno! Okay, Tierno's basically Charon. except way less cool, in my opinion. Robo-Substitute, Luminion, the evolvement of that Pokemon I've never heard of. Also never heard of this one. Reverse Golbat, and... mega super rare version of the card I can't use because it's banned and broken. I knew I was going to get this. Okay, you guys probably tell me I'm lying and I'm just making up something here. I knew I was going to get this card just because of the fact that I can't use it. That would be the rare I get. If I had to get a full art of a trainer, it would be Lysander's trump card. Stupid Lysander's trump card, whatever. It's cool, I like it, it's pretty artwork. Like I said, I'm not even gonna use my physical cards for battles anyway. So, they're really just, you know, pretty cards for decoration. So, it might as well be a card I can't use, right? Because I'm never going to use it anyway. Really, kind of, sort of. You never know. Maybe one day I'll use my real cards for something, but I highly doubt it. Finneon, Poochyena, Seawaddle, Chansey, Gumi, Lampent, Sycamore, Battle Compressor. I don't think I've had that yet. Oh, I bumped the camera. What does this do? Search deck for Rico. Okay. That's fine. Skarmory! Yes!
Yes, look at that.
Oh, yeah! The king has arrived! You're gonna go, like, right... Can I put you, like, right here? You're gonna go, like, right here. Okay, that's not gonna work, is it? You can go right here. You can just stand on top of Florges and Gengar. The king has arrived, folks. Bow down. Oh, I'm so happy about that. I'm so glad I got one. I'm gonna need more than one if I want to build a deck around it, but, you know, that's more important for the online decks. Once again, let me know if you guys would like to see me open the virtual versions of these cards. It'll be a much quicker video. It'll probably be up tomorrow if I get enough people saying it. Blah, 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 blah. More Pokemon I've seen already. One was a Totodile, which is always good. As well as Manectric Spiritually. Don't even either version of Manectric right now. Girafarig, Reverse Bronzor, and the Venomoth. Okay. I like Venomoth, so that's okay. If it's Pokemon I like, I don't really mind if I get a lot of it. I like Venomoth. Falena served me very well, and the Fire Red Nuzlocke. Even though, you know, the Fire Red Nuzlocke was a long time ago, and it was incredibly easy. Because I didn't. That was the point when I kind of knew what I was doing when it came to Nuzlocke, and I didn't really add any extra challenging rules, so I kind of just, you know, destroy everything. Yay, another Zubat. All we need is Crobat now. That'd be really great. That'd be really, really great. Sligoo, Zerosic. Another one of these. A reverse Croconaw and Talonflame. So we've got Mako now. Wow, so we've got a lot of Pokemon that I've used. But then again, I've done a ton of playthroughs. So it's rare that we come across a Pokemon I haven't used or said some sort of weird comment about in one of my playthroughs. So, almost any Pokemon I can make a reference to. Helioptile, kinda, sort of, I don't know. I'm not gonna try to do it, but... Yay, more Totodiles! Alamomola, Rizmer, Lampent, Sycamore, Battle Compressor, Reverse Helioptile, and Crobat! You get to stand right next to Feraligatr. Okay, God, I think you guys get to stand next to each other. You guys were the two I was literally looking for. You two, and hopefully Mega King. I got Mega Gengar and Mega Florges. Not Mega Florges. Okay, hold on. Neither of which were Mega. They were EX. I don't know how many times I've mixed around the word that the time of me doing this. All right, I forgot where I was. Sorry about that. My camera ran out of batteries, so I had not batteries. The memory card room. You know, it ran out of bites, so we had to get some more bites. So we're biting more cards and thing. I don't know. I tried to make a joke, it didn't work. And these are all Pokemon I've seen before. More Golbats, yay! And go reverse Galvantula and Jellicent. Okay. So yeah, I've gotten all the Pokemon I've wanted except for Aegislash. So if we get an Aegislash, we'll have successfully gotten every single Pokemon I wanted to get out of this. I'm already really happy with it. I just wish I could get more than one, but again, that would be more important in the online version to build a deck around it. In the real life version, one is fine. Fletchling, Karrablast, Skarmory, Pupkaboo, Chansey, Lumineon, Tierno, Bulldoor, Jellicent Reverse, and Chandelure! Nice! Oh yeah, Chandelure! Alright, okay. That is really interesting. I like Chandelure as well. I was not good enough to be put up top with the kings, but he is really, I do like him quite a lot. You guys stand up a little bit better. I know it's hard because I keep removing things behind them. So they are kind of going to probably fall by the end of this. In fact, they're kind of falling now. I'll just put them down. Sorry, guys. Take a breather. Did I rearrange the cards? I think I did. Okay. We've got Muna, Fletchling, Roggenrola, Pumpkaboo, Joltik, Girafarig versus Seeker, Loudred, Reverse Slurpuff, and Spalot. That was awful. Awful, awful, pure awful terribleness. Alright. Yeah, it's really hard to think of things to talk about during this except the cards, but I've already talked about all the cards that I've been opening except for, you know, I could look into each and every one and talk about how it might be able to be usable or how it's cool. Well, none have really popped out as I were something to talk about except now I just thought of something. This background is used in a lot of the Pokemon in this set. It's like, there's lots of colors, and they look like cereal. It looks like a fruity cereal. Look at that. Doesn't it look like Fruity Pebbles? I don't know. Just a random thought I had. I told you, I'm going to do this, just having a random thoughts, and I accidentally moved like three cards. Wow, two Lumineons, one's reverse. And Pachirisu is a rare? Why is it a rare? That's interesting. Interesting. You can... Okay, that's so they could force the opponent to be... Well, hold on. The weakness of them is now electric until the end of the next turn. Okay. Okay, because I was going to say, if it's the end of that turn, well, your turn ends when you attack, so what good does that do? Okay. Alright, for this one, we've got Alamola, Whismur, Swirlix, Poochyena, Yanma, Furfru, Tricoin, Zweilous, Reverse Yanma, and Deoncey. Okay, we got our Reverse Deoncey earlier, now we have the real one. So nice. Maybe I should make a freaking fairy deck, because I've got two Deonceys and two Florges EXs. I've got a bunch of Swirlix and Slurpuff, and those actually look pretty good. So honestly, if I was to make a deck out of my real life cards, I think it'd be fairy deck. It looks very viable, to be honest. Like, those were some really nice attacks they all had. They're more supportive, but I feel like they'd work well together. And I'm probably not the first person to think that. Whatever. Karrablast, Chansey, Bunnelby, Zubat, Skarmory, Hanscope, Croconaw, Manectric, Spiritling, Dungeon Valley Reverse, and Mega Sting. I should almost have him up here because of all the freaking Gligars we got in these packs. Alright, there are three remaining. We've got Gengar, Manectric, and Deonti. Let's open them in reverse of how much I like that Pokemon. I got nothing against Deonti. I just like Manectric and Gengar more. So, we shall see if the other Gengar has another Gengar. Wouldn't that be amazing? Purloin, Venonat, Muna, Spearow, Gulpin, Sligoo, Liepard, Golbat, Pachirisu Reverse, and Mega. So we did get a Mega, guys. We got a Mega. We got a Mega. Yeah. They really need to make a Mega Yanmega. Just because. Also, did you know that the Mega in Yanmega's name is not might not necessarily just mean, you know, Mega, like powerful? I think it is actually derivative from an actual word relating to what he is. Like, you know, Zubat, he's a bat who goes Zoo, right? That's where Zubat's name comes from? I think that's what it is. Zubat, Whismur, Murkrow, Fletchling, Helioptile, Gengar Spirit Link, Kingler, Colorless Energy Double Things, Reverse Frillish, and Bronzong. I tried to build that up like it was going to be something cool, but no, I think that killed it. The last pack. The last one. So we've got five really, really good cards. I don't even know if the Flare one is considered a really, really good card. It looks like it is because of all the shininess, but I was not aware of its existence. All right, come on, final pack. Let's finish strong. We've got Pumpkaboo, Litleo, Swirlix, Zubat, Whismur, Fearow, Dimension Valley, roller skates, reverse Swirlix, and Mega Gengar! In the Gengar pack, I saved it for last. We got Gengar and Mega Gengar. This is a good day. We didn't get Aegislash, but that is okay. Was I mistaken? Aegislash is not in this pack? This deck, I could have sworn it was, because, you know, it's on the packs. That is incredible. You guys realize I basically predicted this one on accident. And look, they have the Fruit Loops. The Fruity Pebbles, see? Like, you know, the little Fruity Pebbles around it. Why? Is that explained? Why the Phantom Forces Pokemon, a lot of them have, like fruity Pebbles? Like, they have Fruity Pebbles, is what I want to call them. Alright, well, I'm very happy. I'm very, very happy about this. This is basically making me want to buy even more cards. Well, let's start off with the Kings. They're not the rarest of these super good cards, but they're two of the ones I wanted to find the most, because it's hard to argue against my first and second favorite Pokemons of all time. I wish I got a couple more of them, but I'll wish for that more when I do the virtual pack so I can build decks around them. I actually have an idea for a deck to build, you know, both of them in it. It's really pushing it, like, it's probably gonna suck. Alright, then we got, basically, the Gigantic Troll, the super rare card that I can't use. Then we got this card, which I've never even heard of until I opened it in this pack. Maybe it's good, maybe it's not, but whatever. It's shiny, it's nice. Then we got two Florges EX, one being full art and one being regular. So wow, I think they both look really cool, to be honest. So I'm very happy about that. And then last but not least, we got full art Gengar and Mega Gengar. I think there is a super rare version of Mega, but I don't think it's all that different, Mass. I think it's just a gold border or something. Whatever. So I don't mind that at all. And whatever, a card is a card. The full arts look nicer, but they do the same thing as the regular. But since these cards are basically just decoration, I'm very happy I got the full art. So yes, thank you all for watching my opening of my Phantom Forces booster box. Let me know what you thought, and if I should do these videos again. The problem with it is, I'll tell you right now, the problem I'm running into with doing videos that I like to do randomly is I have a set schedule for videos. I mean, I have a very love-hate relationship with it at the moment, because it's great. You guys guarantee, or almost guaranteed a video, assuming I'm actually caught up on everything, guaranteed a video on Monday, Wednesday, Friday, and Saturday. Monday, Wednesday, Friday are a part of the LP I'm doing, and Saturday is, at the moment, it's Zukunov, but later on it'll be like top 10s and other random things like this. But, I don't know. I guess I can just wait till Zukunov's done, and then I can, you know, use Saturdays for my random stuff I want to post. But at the same time, I don't know. The future has a lot of things that we could do, and I'm looking at the full art of Florges right now. It's like each of the part of Florges has like a different texture to it. It's really hard to tell on the camera, I think. But like the sparkle on the flowers is like spiral shaped, but the sparkle everywhere else is like zigzagged. It's really hard to explain. But that is all for today. Thank you for watching. Let me know if you want me to open the virtual cards on camera, and if you may want to see me do some TCG matches online. I don't know if that'll be interesting at all, but it's an idea I've had, because I really do enjoy the game. I'm just not good at it. But when has not being good at a game stopped me before? Because I feel like I'm not even that good at regular Pokemon, because I feel like I screw up all the time. But whatever. Thank you for watching today's video. Once again, I hope you enjoyed. Thank you for watching, and I just said that. I'm really wasting time. Thank you again. Rock on.